Hello everyone, welcome back to Rome 2 House Julia, the next generation. We continue where we left off in the last episode. You can see the Empire is doing reasonably okay. I mean, you know, predominantly we're dealing with the Gallic Confederation. That's our primary focus right now. We've got this gentleman here over in Berdigal. You can see things are improving. Neminum, we need to get demolished. And we've got one of those in there. So Temple of Minerva is making people generally happier. I mean, to be honest, they're pretty unhappy anyway. Let's see, provincial instability, taxes, slaves.
Commander.
So, yeah. Okay, now, oh, look at this, Bibracte is ripe for an expansion. How lovely. So we'll expand Bibracte, much like my waistline. And this young lady here, oh god, look at him, he's a flipping amazing scout, isn't he? But he's a Gallic Confederate scout, so what I think we'll do is, I'm thinking we need to go for this area here. Because then what will happen is we'll cut off that area, that sort of general sort of place. We'll see. I don't know, Cenobum might be a good place to go.
We hunger for
and that's the doggy army, so you can see there we can upgrade some of our doggies with better armor, so they'll have better fur on them, which is all good. Got this war maiden who's trying to do
attack
general damage to there, and these guys who have
besieging the settlement,
not much in the way of movement, but enough for them to punch this garrison army in the face. So let's start off with that, shall we? It's only fair that we take back Coria from the Gallic Confederations. They stole it from us. I mean, it's just polite, isn't it? I mean, you know. Just a done thing, I suppose. Seems to be quite... We might have a hill advantage here. I mean, that looks to be down in the plains, up on a hill there. Maybe a plain area there. Let's turn the game sounds down. It is excellent, it is dry. We shall start the deployment. Deploy. Right, okay, so these guys are going here. So if we put them there like that, then they'll have the advantage, obviously, of being behind a rock. But we'll move them over to sort of there once we start. Now, the cavalry, we'll put one section over there, and another section of Legio cavalry over there. Now, the general can remain back. Now, these look to be spearmen. So I think what we'll do is we'll put those guys there. And then we'll have these guys behind them. Like so.
Eagle cohorts! Romans ready for two killer infantry.
Right, what we'll do is we'll have the Eagle cohorts at the back. We'll have the Praetorian Guard supporting these fellows here. We'll keep it a sort of quite a compact army under the circumstances, so we can deal with these guys. So let's get underway then. So let's move these guys to there, and we'll set them up for explosive rounds. So these guys are going to start. See if we do the insert. There we go. They're doing their thing. And what we need to do is we need to get the clippity-clops that way. And these other clippity-clops, we'll put them in the hip in there. There's spearmen, swordsmen, fierce swords, there's the general there. So these guys are still getting into position. And we'll move these guys forward. and over.
Riders at the double.
And we'll take our general and put him in safety. So the fierce swords. Are there. Let the bowling commence. There we go. Looking good. Oh, hello, birdie. Get these guys in behind. There we go. In come all the javelins, the spears, and all the other funky good stuff. With the spearmen holding everyone back, hopefully. Yeah, well done, lads. And then these guys. Let's break off that detachment.
The men are wavering.
Oh, shut up. Move these guys forward. Bring these guys up. And these guys up to attack those forces there. Bring these guys over to take out the spearmen. There we go. Actually, let's... Yeah, of course they are.
Missiles awaiting targets. Fellow infantry at your command. Jupiter gives us strength. Missile infantry ready.
Yeah, they're going to get hit from the back.
Legionary cohort.
It's pretty much all over for them. Continue the battle and finish them off, shall we?
Legionary cavalry.
Not sure why they're both going that way.
Forward. Ready and waiting. Legionary cavalry. Advance.
Going to take that lot out.
Legionary cohort.
Let the enemy stay there. Did we lose many of these guys? Let the general get that lot. Move these guys back to here. Come back, guys.
Legionary cavalry.
I'm gonna make sure we wipe them out to a man. Yeah, that's looking okay.
Your orders, come forward. Romans,
ready. Come on, lads, finish him off. There's only 18 of them left. This is where historically most of the casualties in a battle actually came from the killing of fleeing soldiers. There we go. So Gessaurus, we didn't kill the enemy general, but, you know, not really fussed. We did kill most of them. Now, yeah, there we go. We lost a few numbers in my thing, but they killed 60 people, so they did fantastic. And of course, my legionary is doing a great job. Ouch! Straight through the spleen, out through the back of the spine. We shall occupy, thank you. Coria is ours again. And now we've got to rebuild everything again. Okay. So that's great. Corey is wonderful. Let's see how the general map looks now. So we've got this guy, or this lady, I should say, Rufia Balba. The lovely Rufia. Isn't she a wonderful girl? So, Akink is still unprotected. We've got Istros over here. And German Confederation, I think we're at peace with, I'm not sure. Let's just check. German Confederation, German Confederation like us. So, let's see.
Good and noble friend, what an honor you do us. Come, speak so that the spirits can hear your words.
This option demands that a faction becomes your satrapy or client state, taking advantage of your military might in exchange for a percentage of their income.
Thank you. No, that's not going to happen. Let's see. The Gallic Confederation still hate us. Egypt. Let's try some trade.
Friend of Egypt. And speak of you.
No, they don't like us enough.
Trade is beneath the notice of Pharaoh, the all-wise.
Oh, shut up.
Particularly trade with foreigners.
Ugh, dick. Particularly trade with foreigners. Fine, okay, don't trade with me. I'll come and kill you instead. These two here. Now, there's the maiden. We've got this gentleman in Bibract, which is the doggy army. Let's upgrade the general first. Now, Pompeia Ambusta. Fine name, young lady. Now, let's see. Let's send her. Let's send Pompeia over to Cenobum. No, it isn't. Now it can get. Oh.
My path is blocked.
Blocked by that guy. Damn it.
Ready for battle.
So. Let's see. Our armies. We've got an army here. Which we should really leave here for that reason. But these are the armies here that we can make use of.
Ready for battle.
And that army needs to be increased, really. They're a little bit low on cavalry and other troops like that.
At your command.
And these guys obviously looking good. So I'll leave their numbers to replenish. Yeah, we'll leave them for the moment. We don't want to get Lemonum down any further. And let's see. Let's have a look at our money. So we still get 4388 next turn. How are we looking here? So we've made the Imperium. And secure a promotion for our man. So he'll be in Massilia, and he'll be a military tribune. These are other generals and other houses. Let's have a look at the politics. We're still pretty good. We've still got 37% of the senators, so, and we do not have a civil war situation, so it's not too bad under the circumstances. Here we go, 6 turns to replenish those. Now these guys are a minor settlement, so
ready for orders.
We could send Bibract out, because these guys, they got a lot of dogs, but they've got these guys as well. And the numbers are good in Bibract. Let's do that.
Your command.
You have further orders?
So they'll go into Cenobum, which is up here. Cut that section in half, and then we can deal with Nenementum, or however the hell you pronounce that bastard thing. Meanwhile, these guys are at minus 50. What can we do to improve that? That's why, because of that. So we'll worry about that next turn. Now, let's just check research. Armored siege units gives us a weaponsmith, which is excellent. Here we should probably focus. That's all ships and stuff like that, so that's tactics. And ship ram, improve ramming, strategic maneuvers. I mean, here we're pretty au fait. See, that says recruitment costs. See, patrols, Basilica of Neptune. I'm not sure I need that, to be honest. That's the thing. But it would be good to have the management. So I think we might do that to give us that management. We've got that one. And we've pretty much doing that one there. Now, how are we doing civil-wise? Taberna, Market... Yeah, that will probably help there. Labour organisation. Let's start working on some civil stuff. We've done enough military for the time being, I think.
Ready for orders.
Ready so for let's orders. End the turn. I see. A slave uprising, eh? So I guess I need to remove corruption or reduce slaves. Which I will do. I'll reduce them with a sword, but, you know, probably not what they had in mind. Yeah, the Gallic Confederation is up to something, because you can see they're taking a long time to do something. There you go. Horse person has run off. Oh, that's their war maiden, isn't it? The Celtics.
No warrior like standing alone in battle. Should we not be sword brothers and watch for each other?
Okay, I'll have a non-aggression pact with you because then I don't have to worry about you for the time being. Oh, heavens, hello. Right. So we've got legionary cohorts, Evocati cohorts, and plebs. Let's just auto-resolve it. Oh, okay. It's Astrosos or wherever it was. Oh god, they've attacked my ass. Damn it. The Thunderbolts of Tania. We're not going to win that. I've lost my ass. Never mind. A noble thief. One of our guys has died. And our settlement has been sacked. Yes, I know. Istros. Arse. Armored siege units. Military sabotage. General dead. Here's a good one. Okay, so we lost the army here in Istros. Now, where is Istros? It's way the ball's up there, isn't it? And I have this army here. So I think it's time that we send our boys to say hello. Now, we've got this one here. A smallish army. Now, can we use the guys in Coria to intercept them? Okay. Now, we did obviously take that area, Lemonum. So we'll get consecrated ground in there and we'll get a field of Mars. And Nemosos, they're at going plus 5. Berdigala's at 5. They're doing okay. Yeah, Massilia's fine. Bibract, this is the problem, wasn't it? It was Bibract. Cannot build required technology. Damn it. So we've got that. Manipular barracks. Let's put a forum in. That'll help improve things. Coria. Put a blacksmith in and a field of Mars. There we go. This is good. Now Noria over here. Let's put a field of Mars in. Okay, so we're all right money-wise. Let's have a look at Coria.
Ready for orders.
So they're fine at the moment, but we should really send them up to deal with these guys. Now, let's upgrade that cav. And the Eagle cohorts will upgrade as well. Give them extra shielding. And the Pret Guard as well. Okay. So, Massilia is low on numbers. And that's where the slaves are there. And this person moving towards Noria.
We hunger for battle.
Now here are the lovely Suggestica. Give them good shields. Good shields. And just upgrade him anyway. Now, let's look, because a kink is improving. Suggestica also improving. And so I'm thinking that I need to send the Suggestica army up. Yeah, look at that. Suggestica immediately unhappy.
How can I be of assistance?
But I can't really help that at the moment. Hopefully they won't. I mean, they're at what? Minus 2, and it's going up by minus 4, so I've got a little while to play around with. Now, let's see. These fellows. Go down to there. See, look at that. They're at 88, and they've gone to minus 8. But we are remaking everything and upgrading everything now. Civil, let's have a look. Philosophy, construction. This is the one we're after. Here we go. So we can start making more things. And these guys are going to intercept them if we can. And
ready for battle.
These guys are going to go up to Istros and then attack the slaves after that. Now, down here in Ars, they are very unhappy in Ars. So let's do some repairs. Repair everything there.
It is an honor to serve Rome.
And let's get those guys down to help
Fleet reporting.
Reduce some of that unhappiness. So in two turns, they may be okay. We'll have to wait and see how that turns out. But we will need to start doing things soon.
Ready for orders.
Time to attack Cinnabon. Oh crikey, look at that. There was no defences. Fantastic. We shall occupy you.
Ready for orders.
And there we go. Cut in half. Fantastic. Now,
Commander.
Here's these guys. Let's give them some upgrades. Like so, and these are the guys that will be going for this lot. Now, the only drawback is it means that they are going to be pretty unhappy when these guys leave. That's my concern, but we'll go and do it. If we want to cut that section off, and we could do with the wood, that'll be helpful. Who doesn't want wood? Generally.
Ready for orders.
And so we'll go that one, and we'll go that one. We'll get rid of those two. We can hopefully improve the situation there. And then let's see. Send our lovely spy mistress. Oh, hello.
My road is barred. Can I be of more assistance?
You can always be of more assistance, my dear.
Commander.
Okay.
We hunger for battle.
I'm sure we do. So these guys are going to go and deal with that lot.
Let them cower before Rome.
Indeed, let them. So that means we will then have this section, Normandy and that sort of area of France, which would be great. This guy is literally just a small army just to hold Massilia and keep them happy. Let's see. This gentleman here will be dealing with the Swords of Clay. And this gentleman will be going up to Istros. So let's end the turn. Yep, here comes the Gallic Confederation. What are they up to? I see. Natural causes. Publius Cornelius Scipio. We've lost Scipio. Oh dear, never mind. So, let's see. He's a good commander. We'll have him. and in Berdigala. Okay. Cultism, okay. It's a bit of a worry. Let's upgrade him. Hidden agent has been exposed.
Ready for orders.
Now, Trouble Populous is in Cartagenesis or Genesis. Where is this? Yeah, it's the people of Ars. Understandably so. But we're rebuilding stuff there. What's that? Advanced construction techniques. Yeah, so it's like concrete. There we go. See, all that stuff. Unhappy populace. Sinia. Istros, of course, because of the revolting slaves who are very revolting. Let's get these guys into Istros now. And they can then deal with those slaves. Goodness me, there's quite a few of them. More unhappy populace. Let's do that with the Temple of Mars in Berdigala. That's good, 40 wealth. That gives us 60 wealth, 7 food. But it gives us minus 1 public per order. Yeah, we'll go with. We'll go with grain pits. I know what you're thinking, that's the pits, but no. Right, so. Berdigala. What do we need more of? I think we need 2 of those. And we'll put some Vilites in there as well. The Vigiles and the Legionary Cohort can wait. But that will do for now. In the meantime, Cenobum will build Consecrated Ground next turn. They're still quite happy. So, let's go and say hello to Namnatum and make them significantly unhappy. It's raining, what do you know? It's fogging, it's raining, and it's fog. God damn it. Being fogged up, not good. Right, so what we'll do is over one side here, we'll put Horsey, and over the other side here. Swift. We'll put Horses. And let's have a look at the actual layout. So that tends to be the entrance there. We can get in there as well. Okay. What I think I'm going to do is I'm going to split the forces. Put 4 sections there. And we'll put the remaining other sections there. We'll have these guys supported by Vilites there. And Vilites there. And we'll keep the general back. So we've got a good split here. Let's get the riders in and see what they can do. Oh, hello.
I will call myself a Vestal and retire to the temple. Now, let us take this place.
Right, let's get those guys over.
Horsemen! Quickly now!
Let's get the horsemen into there. Fast. If we can.
Mounted warriors!
Now, what options do we have for the centre of town? It's there, isn't it? Rawr indeed, thank you. So we'll take these guys and bring them into there. We get these guys.
Legionary cohort! At the double! At speed! Happy to serve Rome! Quick
bring them up to there. Here's going to be where the main fight is going to occur. Get them, lads.
Glory to Rome!
Legionary cohort!
Our hidden units have been discovered.
What do you mean, discovered?
Victory for Rome!
Right. There's the clippity-clops there.
Horsemen!
Let's bring the horsemen in here. Got here. We've got some swordsmen and stuffs. So the point is that we've intercepted their reinforcements. It's kind of what we wanted.
Legionary cohort! Marching order!
Let's get these two guys up here.
At the double.
And then have these two guys waiting. Alright, let's get these guys in.
On me. Light horse.
Benito's there. Those guys ready. Get the Velites to support them. Some spearmen there.
Legatus! Cavalry!
Let's get the cavalry down the center now.
Mounted death! Ride out!
Our hidden units have been discovered.
Oh, shut up. Those guys there are keeping that one. Who's being discovered? Get the skirmishers. Kill them all.
Our horses love blood.
Hello, boys. Didn't expect that, did you? Have that, you bitches. Those guys start capturing the point. Keep an eye on the battle over here. How's it progressing? Yep, there we go. Get them. Alright, what's going on here? Get them, please. Bring these guys round. Get the horsemen into the back of those guys. Get the fierce swords involved.
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
There we go, looking good. These guys continuing to move towards the center. They look like they've been broken. There we go.
Our unit has used all its ammunition.
Where are the fierce swords, though? Those are the guys we need to kill. Get all of them dead.
Sons of Mars.
Where are they?
Our hidden units have been discovered.
Legionary cohort, General.
Yeah, General, you can get them.
Horsemen.
Right. Bring these guys down to there. And then we can use this horse to run down the remainder of the forces. But I don't see them anywhere. Yeah, I don't see anybody. Except for these guys, obviously.
General!
Advance at speed!
Oh well, that'll have to do. Only four left on the general. God damn it. That would have been nice, but never mind. He lost nearly everyone. When he lost 46 men. Yeah, we kick ass. And he's coughing again. Wonderful. There we go. We shall peacefully occupy.
At your command.
And Nomentum will get demolished. Like so. We'll turn that into a something shortly. Okay, interesting, we can't demolish that port. So, there we go. Now, the Edetani minor settlement. They're also down here in the provincial capital. Now, let's see, Ars, how are you? Ars are not happy. Bunch of asses. Right, okay. So this is where predominantly most of the enemy is coming from. So let's send these guys back to Bibracte. They can then deal with them if they attack us, and these guys will act as support if they do. And then we need to start taking this interior section here. Now there's a Gallic Confederation fellow who's literally all on his lonesome. We've obviously just taken there, so we need to give that time to bed in and to make them happier. See, we've done all of that there. And we still need to deal with these slaves.
At your command. Set up the
so watch. Those guys are going to go into Istros. We can't repair anything in Istros at the moment. We'll leave that. What are they on? 65, so that'll take you to what? 83. And over here is the German Confederation. So let's see. They are very friendly with me. I have no argument with the German Confederation.
There's a good pork roasting for you, and better ale and mead set aside. But first,
we have a non-aggression pact. So that's good. So we won't attack those guys. We may need to work on the guitar though. We'll see. This gentleman, he is off to Istros to deal with that outbreak. Now minus six. Why are the kinkies on minus six? Right, because we've had to rebuild some stuff and repair stuff. Okay. That's fair enough. Now, the Getae, are they... They hate me. Why do they hate me? They're hostile. Trespasses, past war, culture aversion, expansionism, military, yeah. Yeah, don't care. Doesn't matter, you won't be around for long.
Are you brave or foolish?
Yeah, whatever. Big talk. Now, that could be an issue. Galatia like me. We are trading. So why don't
we? Met friend. Sit and let your words move me.
Oh, we have a non-aggression pact, so they won't attack us. That's good. Well, at least we hope they won't. But we might be able to use that as a shoot to get in there. See, we're non-aggression there, non-aggression there. But it might be an opportunity for us to sort of take that there. But we need to deal with the slave rebellion first up here. And this gentleman here. Where is he going? Let's send him to Noria. Hopefully he will... Yeah, he's improved the general happiness there for the moment, so... Let's leave him there. Korea is doing okay. So there's Bibracht.
At your service. My skills are yours.
No, she doesn't have the ability to do anything at the moment. We'll just keep her there. And there's Cinnabon. So, these guys here, minus 18, obviously, because we've just taken them over, they're going to be a problem. So what I think we might do is we might raise an army in there. Let's have a look at Cinnabum and put consecrated ground in. Generally improve the situation. Oh, we've done a Malekith. We forgot we had some. And assigned skills, here we go. Let's have a look at our boy. Right, so he's got authority, gravitas, cultural conversion. What other options do we have here? Artillery command. Naval assault, cavalry command. Infantry command. Warrior strategist. Let's give him infantry command. Sounds like a good one to me. Here's the Editani. Persia. What are they up to? Rebellion imminent in Hercynia. Istros, of course it's rebellion imminent.
Commander,
get into Istros. Thank you. Now, Istros needs to be repaired. No, that's too expensive, I think. But the point is that the slave rebellion is still going on. Oh, look at all that construction. Fantastic. Encourage populace in Celtica. So, let's put in consecrated ground. And let's put in a field of Mars. And let's put in a port. And a cough. And this is Nementum. Over here, isn't it? Yeah. Now, these guys, yeah, it could be helpful. Put a field of Mars in there and a... another cough, god damn it. A villa. Put that in as well. God damn it, I do still wish I'd stop coughing, man. Really annoying. $2,400, no. Okay. So, what I think I need to do is Cenobam's okay. Nementum is being rebuilt. With more timber. That's literally like one person.
We hunger for battle.
Bibract is still going down. So let's get them into Bibract. That will improve things. Now, let's have a look. Britannia down here is still going down. But why is the question? Provincial instability, okay, so that's understandable. So they've got that army in there. We've got Lemonum. Given that should improve their happiness, or at least their cultural differences. Let us see, there's that guy there. And that guy's over here, isn't he?
At your command.
Now I'm tempted to send him out to deal with that. Play that as a cultural area. See, that's 48, so we can still move these guys.
Advance.
So we've got some time.
Your next command.
That's going to be our next attack. Deal with that guy. Now, let's move up to here.
Ready for battle.
And let's see what these guys need. So they're repairing that Shrine of Minerva. That'll create more public order.
Ready for orders.
Okay. So we'll save the money on creating another army for the moment. Noria. What is making Noria so unhappy? Well, public order's still increasing. Well, it's 83, so they're not unhappy. They're good. So I think what we'll do is send these guys from Noria up to the likes of these places. Now, do they have any kind of artillery? Yes, they do. Good. Right. They've got a full movement capacity, which is good.
Ready for orders.
Come in. Okay. Now, you see, they're still at minus four. I'm thinking. Yeah, he's a warlord, isn't he? No, we'll leave it. We'll leave that for now. These guys are going to attack there. And let's just check to see what's going on down here. So Berdigala will be happier. Commander. And then once they're done, we will move these guys from Berdigala. Celtic? Really? Okay. Let's see. Yeah, they hate us. Alright, let's see who we're not trading with but don't hate us. Alright, let's see.
Welcome, friend. Welcome. Come, sit.
Good. Thank you.
I will.
So we're trading with pretty much everyone we can trade with right now. So it's possible we could send these guys here around, maybe up to here, and bring in another army sort of from another direction. That could be quite interesting. So we'll be attacking them from two directions. That would be very nice. We won't worry about the British for the time being until we've dealt with the continent. Predominantly France, Germany and Denmark. Good, they're starting to push back against the Galatia, which is good. So that's next on the plan. But I think that's where we're going to end it this week. I hope you guys have enjoyed. And I'll see you again soon.